Down here, not just the 15 years that we've been out here together, but the time between us, we've been out here 70 years. Do you know that?
Thank you for clarifying that.
Well, I'm not that old yet.
No,
not yet.
With any luck at all,
right?
With any luck at all, we'll get there. But
no, I wanted to say something. Though. I wanted to tell something.
Yeah,
about you.
Do go on.
Thank you. No, I wanted to say that, you know, it's so nice. We were standing backstage, and she said, "Wow, can you believe that people came?" I said, "Well, we had tickets on sale." She said, "Yeah." You start naming all the things that people can do online, and gamble online, and all kinds of stuff. You didn't have to come out and see us live, you know, and they did. And there's a lot of competition for us.
So much competition.
There's
300 channels. And there's all kinds of stuff, and a million acts have come up since we started out.
That's right. Yeah, a lot of them. And we're all out there together. I'm surprised our buses aren't a big convoy down the interstates, because there's so many of us out here singing and playing, and, you know, home and our crowd's going to be the best one. We've got the best one.
Woo!
What I was telling you that for is because every night, Pam comes to my dressing room and she's like, "Do you think anybody's gonna come out today?" I said, "Pam, there's cars in the parking lot. I'm trying to say something." She said, "Maybe somebody else is playing." She's paranoid, really paranoid. I'm sorry, I'm telling the story.
You're kind of exposing my vulnerabilities.
I'm gonna pay you back a little bit from a minute ago. So every night I have to calm her down before we go on stage. They're going to love you, Pam. I promise they're going to love you.
Woo! Yes!
Woo! We're going to sing this next song.
Because it goes right along with what you're saying.
Right along with what I'm saying.
It does. And it's written by, we did an album of a lot of our very favorite country covers, and a lot by the ladies of country music. And one we want to mention that we don't feel like is mentioned near enough these days, and we don't want anybody to forget about K.T. Osmond.
Woo!
Yes. And she said it better than I ever could, and it's okay, Lori. I'm the worrier. I'm the worrier of the bunch.
Questions that I'm asking, you could ask them on there too.
You used to get it when you see me coming up the hill. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Do you whisper my name just to bring a little comfort to you? Hallelujah. Do you still like the feel in my body lying next to you? But I guess what I'm asking is, do you still love me, do you? Oh, but I guess what I'm asking is, do you still love us, do you?
So great. This is all about our philosophy in life. Are we going to philosophize now?
We'll philosophize.
Okay, let's do it.
Jesus in his grave.
Woo!
I'm cranky kid. We've been saying that all day long.
Have y'all seen that little boy?
Look up cranky kid on YouTube. Yes.
Cranky little boy on YouTube.
This is. I've had a hard day at school. It's just about 4 or 5 years old. I'm tired and I'm cranky. I'm tired, I'm cranky. His dad says, we might want to wrestle later. He said, well,
maybe.
Maybe. I'm tired and cranky.
we are proud to be out here carrying on a family tradition, you guys.
Woo!
We grew up around the ways of country music. First of all, as we mentioned, great ladies like KT.
Yeah.
And we had a lot of heroes.
I love Tammy Wynette, was my idol.
Yeah. Woo!
And we mentioned KT, Donnie West, loved her. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
I wanted to grow up to be just like Dolly Parton. It did not work out. I think you're almost there.
But maybe.
The trail was blazed for us by our daddies.
Woo!
Yeah.
Yes. I say this in my shows that, you know, we didn't really get to know each other that well until we started. You put this show together acoustically, even though our dads, the late great, my dad was George Morgan.
Woo!
Thank you so much.
Yes. Woo!
And of course, you know, Pam's wonderful dad, the late great Mel.
Woo!
We miss them, but we like to think that, well, we believe that they are looking down after us as we go down the road. Yes. I feel it. Not only that, but when we were first putting the show together, speaking of YouTube, it's funny because we started doing this on the stools, and she sat there, she sits there, and I sit here always. And one night we were still kind of working it out, but we happened to look up, said, you think Daddy and your dad ever worked together? And she found his daddy.
Yes.
and Mr. Morgan, and they were on the Porter Wagner show. Your daddy was the fill-in host for the Porter Wagner show.
Yep.
And this is the crazy thing. They were sitting on two stools just like this. Her daddy was there. My daddy
That's
was
right.
there.
That's right.
And,
wow.
And if that won't bring a tear to your eye, you better yank a nose for
right.
me.
Woo!
I'm choked up. So we're
riding down the road on our bus, you know, and my dad was, they ended up being a really good friend. They fished and went out, you know, did things together, whatever. But my dad looked over at Mel, he called him Melvin. He said, you know, Melvin, I've always wanted to record, because Mel was a great songwriter. I mean,
woo! Yes.
The best.
Yes.
Just hands down, great country songwriter. And he looked at Mel and he said, you know, Mel, I've always wanted to record a Mel Tillis song. And what'd your dad say?
Daddy reached behind his back and he pulled out a notebook and he said, well, I just happen to have about 500 of them.
And they were great friends.
They were. And they were funny people. Funny people to be around. Both of them had a great sense of humor. But that's, I'm proud we adopted that as well. We
have to muscle
down.
Don't take yourself too serious. We have a lot of fun when we're out here on the stage. But we always like to remember our daddies. And we worked up a medley of George Morgan and Mel Tillis. So we're going to work.
Woo!